Welcome back. You're watching Money, Money, Money. And this week, we are discussing the steps to ensuring a secure, financially happy retirement. Well, the first step perhaps is going to be to set the target. How much money do you need to actually have in place by the time you are retiring at 60 or 62, as the case might be? Sunil, I'll open with you. What's the math?
Sure. It depends on your standard of living, your income generation capacity, etc. But the biggest mistake most of the investors make is that they do not take into account the impact of inflation while creating a corpus for retirement and other goals. So just to give you an example, if they think that if they had 1 crore in their retirement kitty today, that today's cost of living, they'll be happy. They start saving and investing to achieve that 1 crore over the next 30 years. Now you can imagine with that 8% or a 6% inflation, at the age after 30 years, when they actually retire, they would have needed a corpus of 10 crores and not 1 crore. Mm. So ideally what they should be doing is sitting with their financial advisors, understanding the impact of inflation, what is the current standard of living, and what at today's cost of living, if they had to retire as of today, what would they be happy with? If that is the starting point, and then adding on to that the inflation index, and then arriving at that 10 crore number or a 5 crore number, and then finally working backwards to understand which asset class, at what rate of return, and finally how much money will they need to save and invest every month to achieve that 5 crore or a 10 crore corpus, which is an inflation adjusted corpus.
Sure. Gaurav, how do you go about advising on this? I mean, how to set that target? And is the retirement corpus purely a spending corpus through which you can live the next couple of years? Does it also have an element of perhaps some of the medical costs that you might have to incur?
Right. So first is try and find out what will be your contingency requirement. So these are basically three steps. Your emergency requirement, your regular income. If there are major events that are still pending, it could be children's education, which you may have to fund. There could be their marriage. And obviously, small portion of amount or a large portion or some portion of amount dedicated for healthcare. Because a lot of these healthcare and insurance plans are not sufficient to take care of all possible expenses. And hence, you may want to create a particular kitty, which you are saying that whatever insurance does not cover, we are going to have this.
Preeti, just wanted your thoughts on an aspect that Gaurav raised, and that is the kind of products that are available for health. Because that becomes obviously a huge component of the expenses, especially once you're nearing retirement or even post-retirement. How do you look at the benefits that are available right now, whether it's within the working corporate life or beyond, when it comes to just securing yourself health-wise?
Some of the public sector undertakings who've had pension programs, they also have something called a post-retirement medical benefit. So where the sponsor is the pensioner. That is because they are aligned to people who are together because they're pensioners, etc. So that's a group. The challenge that we have in the other private sector companies is there is no...
Once you're out there's of...
The, yeah, it's a lump sum. It's a lump sum, right? So there's no pension available for them. So how do they group together? But we have seen very recently that at least, I would not say they're beyond even single digit, but then slowly we're seeing companies, the alumni of the organization getting together, forming a group, and that becomes a group where you can actually go and purchase group medical programs. And that's a very good way. So
But a lot of these people would be either senior citizens or very close to that age. Yet are they able to negotiate?
Yes, they should be able to because honestly, I can still go and buy a health insurance beyond 60. It is just that when I go as an individual,
you hardly get sort of the benefits.
The underwriting standards, everything relating to that product are very different, because obviously health is a big expense for people as they advance in age, because all of us seem to be living longer, but are we going to live healthy is a big question mark.
Okay, all right. On that note, another quick break. But when we come back, we boil it down, distill it down to the basics. Now, you need to create a large enough corpus. Should it be EPF? Should it be NPS? Should it be mutual funds? Or should it be a mix of all of these? That math on the other side of the break.